Alright, let's see this. Because we know the transformation of 1, 1 and 1, negative 1, right? But right now, they want us to compute the transformation from 1, 4. Therefore, we want to use something about domain here by using the domain that we know, which is 1, 1 and 1, negative 1. The easiest way is that we need to write in terms of linear combination. So I just write 1, 4 in terms of linear combination. And how are you going to solve for A and B? You see here, we have what? A plus B equal to 1. A minus B equal to 4, right? Like this. A plus B equal to 1. A minus B equal to 4. Okay, let's call this equation 1 and here equation 2. When you add them up, B cancel out. So you have 2A equal to 5. So A equal to 2.5. And you just choose one equation. Let's say here I choose the second equation. So if I want to find B, B comes from A minus 4. So 2.5 minus 4 is negative 1.5. Here we go. So you know A 2.5 and B negative 1.5. Similarly, for this one, if you want to compute T of negative 2, 1, you see, we only write, we find the relationship between what we know, right? The point that they give us and the point that they want us to find. What's the easiest way to find relationship? It has to be what? Linear combination, right? Which we know we can find linear combination of that. Another question that your friend asking, just kind of like confusing between domain, range, image, pre-image. Okay. Here we go. You have domain, you have range, okay? Which one comes first in your hands, whatever, okay. Let's say this one domain and this one range. So the domain we call, okay, in this paper, domain, range, domain, codomain. So the range and codomain are exactly the same thing. Pre-image, pre usually comes from, right? Pre is like before, ahead, or in the front, pre, right? Pre-image is domain. Image is going to be range. So for domain, pre-image, they are the same thing. Range, image, codomain, they are the same thing. All right, is that clear? And if you want to check for linear transformation, you need to check two properties. Preserve additivity or not? Preserve scalar multiplication or not? Okay, good to go. What else? Okay, let's see here. Something simple. In this section, I'm going to teach you two definition, kernel and range. Kernel and range. If you have V and W be two vector spaces, T be linear transformation mapping from, mapping means the function. Mapping, function are the same thing. From V to W, and T is linear transformation too. All right, so the first definition, kernel, see? This one and this one. Okay, the two sentences that I just highlighted. Kernel, denoted by K-E-R of T, kernel T, kernel of T. Okay, I see I got a message. Could you explain exercise 6.1.7? 6.1.7? What is that? Okay, sure. We have T as a linear transformation. When you see R3 and R3 means that whatever you plug in is codomain is going to be R3. So it's going to be order triple. The result, the range, codomain. Okay, let me note here just in case you can forget it or you can follow that. Domain, pre-image are the same thing. Range codomain and image are the same thing for this one. So let's see in this exercise. If you see R3, that means we talking about order triple ABC. This is what they give you. T of 100, T of 010, T of 001, they give you the value. The things that you plug in T comes from domain. The result is called range, image, or codomain belong to here. Still be R3. This is what you want to compute. You see, you don't see the pattern of the transform, but they just give you in terms of the transform of three numbers. The technique you need to find this term in terms of linear combination of the domain that you know. This is the domain that they want you to find, right? You plug in this number as a domain and you want to compute means you want to find image. You want to find the range, the result. But you don't know the form of the transformation. It's different from here. This one, they tell you the transformation. Whatever you plug in, this is the form that you're going to get. But here, they don't tell you about the form. They just tell you the number. So you need to find some relationship between the new thing with the something that we know. Okay, so to write this in terms of linear combination, how are you going to do this? Actually, from here, okay, about this line, okay, exercise 6.1.7, okay, you have relationship that I'm talking about this line. Negative 2, you see, minus 2, 4, and 1, no, minus 1, is equal to what? Is equal to this term, you see that? Negative 2 times something, but actually this one comes from what? A times 1, 0, 0, plus B times 0, 1, 0. Plus C times 0, 0, 1. You see that? This is what we need to find first. And then how are we gonna find A, B, C? Here we go, you see? This one actually A, and this one actually B, and this one actually C. So negative 2, 4, and minus 1 equal to A, B, C, exactly. So A equal to minus 2, B equal to 4, and C equal to what? Negative 1, right? Just like this number. You see that? Therefore, we can write this thing that we need to find the value of the transformation in terms of linear combination. Once you can write this, why we need to write this? Let's come back here. Because we know that, okay, once you write in this form, you know that if you have, let's see, x equal to y plus z, okay, suppose we have this. When you take t into x, it's the same thing as you take t into y plus z. See that? And because t is linear transformation, so this term, you can distribute t to each term. It's going to be ty plus tz. Here we go. And if you can write this, you can see here. So t of this term, right, is equal to t of this term plus t of this term plus t of this term. You can transform each of these. And these three numbers are given already. You see that? You know the value. Then you just plug in the number and do the calculation. Do you understand? Nishapa, is that better? You want some coffee? Can I move on? Any more questions? Why w y minus 2 doesn't multiply with vector? Still are in the same problem, right? Y minus 2, why is it? This one? Oh, I see. This is wrong, you're right. So when you do this, okay, to make it clear, let's copy here. Okay, I'll do it for you. Since, and our A will be what? Minus 2, B will be 4, and C will be minus 1. Okay, since you know this, after we take the linear transformation to get, this is what we get. Still using this one. Good questions. That's a typo. I just focus on the idea. Okay, this is what we have. T of this, actually you're supposed to have negative 2 in the front times and 4 times T of this minus 1 times T of this. See that? Okay, so Nishapa, you're right. Therefore, from here, this example, you see that? You need to plug in. It's actually equal to what? This term, the transformation of 1, 0, 0 is what? 2, 4, minus 1. So here you need to multiply with 2, 4, minus 1. Plus 4 times transformation of this turn out to be what? 1, 3, minus 2. 1, 3, minus 2. And the last term, transformation of this will be 0, negative 2, 2. Okay? And then we do the calculation of this. This term equal to what? It's supposed to be... Okay, to make it clear. So here, you multiply with negative 2 inside here, you're gonna get negative 4, negative 8, and 2. Okay? And this term you multiply with 4 in here, you're gonna get 4, 12, minus 8. And this one multiply with negative 1, right? So it just put negative in here. That's it. And then you can combine all of these. You're going to get what? Minus 4 plus 4 and minus 0. So it's equal to 0. And from here, minus 8 plus 12, you get 4. 4 plus 2, 6. And the last term, 2 minus 8 minus 6. Minus 6 minus 2. Minus 8. Did you get this answer, Nishapa? Okay. All right. So this is wrong. Thank you for letting me know. Yeah, sorry. I just focused on like how you're gonna solve it, but I didn't check out the typo here. You see, I just see, oh, they multiply it with the number, but actually here they forgot to multiply minus 2, forgot to multiply 4, and forgot to multiply minus 1 here. So this is not the right answer. The right answer should be here. At least me and Nishapa got the same solution. You're welcome, ka. Any more questions, guys? Otherwise, we're gonna talk about kernel. Okay, kernel is what? Kernel is gonna be all the set of V such that TV equal to zero vector. If you plug any V in here and you get the result equal to zero vector, all the set V here is a kernel. Kernel is a domain or the set from domain that make the transformation become zero. Any function or any vector that you plug in and make the transformation here equal to zero, this vector here is called kernel. What about the range? The range is just what? The range is W after you plug in. Okay, range will be if you pick up some domain, right? For some V in V, you plug in, you get W. The set of W here is going to be, it means just the range, the result, the image, the core domain is called range. Range is just range. The value after you plug in the domain, the value after you plug in the domain will be range. But kernel will be the number from the domain, the vector from the domain that you plug in and make the transformation become zero. Okay. This one just tell you about the property of isomorphism. T is isomorphism if T is 1 to 1 and on to, and it is follow that just a property if T is isomorphism, if the kernel T equal to set of 0, that means 0 is the only set that make T 0 equal to 0. 0 is the only set that make T 0 equal to 0. And the range equal to W because like right now T is mapping from B to W. So range just be like the range, you know, like nothing new for range. Just kernel. Kernel or the vector that make transformation become zero. All right, next one, matrices for linear transformation. In this section, we will focus on what? The linear transformation involving with matrix. Before we move on, let's see the standard basis in Rn. E1, E2, E3, up to En. What does it mean? E1 means we have 1 at the first position, the rest will be 0. E2 at the second position will be 1, the rest will be 0. Up to En, the last position will be 1 before that. R or 0. See the definite, see the theorem say that if T transform from Rn to Rm, all right, bilinear transformation, and you can transform E1 and you get this, you see, belong to Rm, m term. E2, you get this m term. En, you get this. Then they say that we can construct. Remember when I mentioned about how you're gonna construct the transform. If I ask you to find matrix A that make TV equal to AB, that means if you plug in any V in here, it's turned out to be AB. You can construct matrix A here, which is called standard matrix from what? The first column represents by T of E1. The second column comes from T of E2. The last column comes from T of En. Okay, just talk about column by column. So if I ask you, find the standard matrix A. Okay, this is the question. Find the standard matrix A by given T transformation. That means this means you need to find A such that this one telling you that you need to find A such that T of V is equal to A V. Okay, and how you gonna find A? You can construct A equal to, okay, this is gonna be your matrix. The first column will be T of E1. What does it mean E1? Oops, E1. E is standard basis. The second column will be T of E2. And so on, up to the last one is gonna be T of En. Okay, this is how you construct. All right. Let's see example. Oh, before example, see the property here a little bit. T1 is a function from Rn to Rm. T2 come from Rm to Rp, okay? And what else do we know? Okay. This theorem. Okay, especially this line is really important. T1 and T2. This one is gonna be two linear transformation. The composition, you know, composite function. Remember the composite function, FOG is F of what? Recall composite function. FOG was OG is a fork. It's FOG of X is equal to F of g of x, remember? Here we go. And this one, we also can apply the composite function into linear transformation. How are we gonna do that? You see that? If T1 start from Rn to Rm, T2 start from Rm to Rp, okay? To get the function from Rn to Rp, be careful, it's not T1 or T2, okay? It's not T1 or T2, but it's T2 or T1, you see? That means when you're dealing with a function, you're gonna, just like this, what's gonna contact X first? G, right? So this one, the function or the transformation that's gonna contact domain gonna be T1 first. So you're gonna start from Rn. And then you're gonna go ahead to use T2, which is what? End up with Rp. Here we go. So this one, you're going to have T2 or T1. And T1, you contact the domain. So you use the domain of T1, which is Rn. And T2 giving you result of Rp. So the transformation start from Rn to Rp. Keep this in mind. Next. If you have linear transformation, you will always be able to construct the standard basis, right? Right now, they're telling you that T1 give you the standard basis A1, and T2 give you the standard basis A2. If you find a composite of the linear transformation T2 or T1, you're gonna get the standard basis, the new standard basis come from A2 times A1. Order is important. A2 times A1 is not equal to A1 times A2 in terms of matrix, right? The product of matrices A, B is not equal to BA right you probably like okay Ajahn if you say so no it's not I say so because after today you need to read all of this and then I'm gonna give you some sample tests with the answer but before I give you the answer I would like you to give a try by yourself a little bit before you come and check with the answer right so let's listen about this one more time you have what you have two transformation first of all let's make it clear here every time you have transformation TV equal to AV you always be able to find A here is called standard matrix How you gonna construct A? You use the transformation that I give you. Put the first column here by using T of E1. The second column will be T of E2. And so on up to T of EN. It depends on like, if you in R3, you just have T1, T2, T3. If you in RN, you have T1, T2, T3, up to TN, T of EN. But here, it's different. You have two transformation. The first one here. T1 mapping from RN to RM, T2 mapping from RM to RP. But when you write in terms of composite linear transformation, no, it's not like T2 and T1 and it's gonna come from this term first. No. Think about when you hit the function, just like F or G, G gonna hit the X first. So T1 gonna meet the X first, the domain. So we're gonna use a domain here, but we end up with T2. T2, the last term gonna be RP. So the new mapping gonna be RN to RP. See? And if you have standard basis, the first transformation give you the first standard basis. The second transformation give you the second standard basis. If you find the standard matrix. If you want to find the standard matrix for the composite linear transformation, it's going to be A2 times A1. All right. Next definition. Okay. This one just say invertible. If T1 and T2 mapping in the same domain and range, RN to RN, R2 linear transformation. Okay, now V, for V in RN, in this case, you can say that if you have T, this one telling you that T2 or T1 equal to T1 or T2, okay, you can say that T1 and T2 are invertible if and only if all right you can show that T1 or T2 see is equal to T2 or T1 and they are equal to whatever you plug in there, right? Let's say this one T1 or T2X equal to T2 or T1X is equal to X. So in this case, it's equal to V, right? Based on this. If you see something like this, this one, we say that T2 is invertible of T1 or T1 is invertible. So if E1 is invertible, T2 gonna be invertible too. This is the meaning of invertible. If I ask you, check to see if T1 and T2 are invertible or not, that means you need to show me these two things. T2 or T1 of V equal to V or not, and T1 or T2 of V equal to V or not. Show two things. Check, show invertible meanings that show two things. This one You need to show what? T1 or T2 of V is equal to V and T2 or T1 of V also equal to V. Okay, I'm telling you already, this is what you need to show. It won't be hard, you know, just spend some time on showing that. Next, they said if you have T as a linear transformation from Rn to Rn, and A will be your standard matrix of T. Okay, standard matrix. When we talk about standard matrix, you know that the way they construct A will be like this. See that? The first column T of E1, the second column T of E2, and so on. The following are equivalent. The first one, T is invertible. Second, T is isomorphism. Hey, what does it mean, isomorphism? Let's come back here. They talk about isomorphism. Where is it? Here we go. Isomorphism, if the kernel of T equal to zero set only, and the range will be the whole range W, or 1 to 1 and on 2, right? Okay, I know you hate this word, okay? Because you guys probably forgot about isomorphism already. And A is invertible. So if invertible, that means you need to show these two things that we mentioned here. Invertible means what? The inverse exists. Okay, next one. Let's talk about basis. When we talk about basis, you need to check what? Two things. First of all, linearly independent. The second one, anyone remember? Span, correct. Tanvi, did you just say span? Oops, you're right. No. Okay. If you're sleepy, take a deep breath, and you're gonna feel better. Okay. Suppose you have T. Is a mapping from V to W. Mapping is a function. It's a linear transformation between two vector spaces, V and W. All right. So B defined like this is the basis of V. B prime is a set of W here, is the basis of W. And if you can write T of V1 equal to W1 to Wm times A1, A21, and so on to Am1, writing similarly, okay. Now you have two bases, okay. Actually, this one is gonna be big W, is typo. You find basis of this, you find basis of this, okay? Let you have B consists of this, is a basis of B. B prime contains of all this vector, is a basis of W. Okay? And if you can find that TV1, TV2, TVN, you take T to each vector here, but you write in terms of column. You see, you don't have any comma anymore. You write in terms of matrix. So you put the first column from TE1, TE2 up to TEN, and it's equal to W. You see, W1, the first column, W2, W3 up to WN times this coefficient. Okay, right now, let's say you don't know what is that. And they just say, then T is determined by A with respect to basis B and B prime. I'm not sure if we're gonna have the example for this. Okay, let's hang this here first. Let's see example. Okay, let's skip a little bit about basics now. Let's say you have this transformation. If you plug any xyz in here, you're gonna get this form out. It's gonna be 5x minus 3y plus z. The second element gonna be 2z plus 4y, and the last element will be 5x plus 3y. Okay. What is a standard matrix? Remember, if they ask you to find standard basis, that means you need to construct A. This is the standard matrix. Okay, let's say standard matrix. You need to see, right now she's mapping from what? When you see three elements, that means we have R3. So you need E1, E2, and E3. And TE1, TE2, TE3, you just plug in E1 in there, plug in E2 in T, and E3 in T, and then you transform by using what? This. You're gonna get each number. And the first column, you write TE1, the second one, you write TE2, and here will be TE3. And this will be the standard matrix. Is that easy? Right? It's easy, right? Okay, like that. And if you have in terms of this, now you see if you transform, you plug in R3, the result will be R2 because you have two, like it's order pair, right? Write down the standard matrix of T and use it to find T of this. You need to find standard matrix. When we find standard matrix, they right now, they're telling you that if you find A, you're gonna get the transformation in terms of TV equal to AB or TX equal to AX. But before you can plug in any X that they ask you, you need to find A first. And now you see the domain when you plug in this is in terms of order triple. So that means it should be in what? It should be in R3. So this one, E1, E2, E3, still gonna use this form. E1, E2, and E3 in R3. You plug in here and you get E1 equal to this, right? You plug in X equal to 1 and Y will be 0. And here Y and Z will be 0. So E1 will be this. TE2, TE3, you see that? When you have that, construct A. This is your A. TE1, TE2, TE3. Here we go. After you know A, now use it to find T of 0, 1, and negative 1. TV equal to AV. TV, 0, 1, negative 1 equal to A times whatever you want to find. 0, 1, negative 1. You know A. Plug in here. You know B. The problem given, calculate the matrix, and this is the answer. You see that? So if I ask you something like this, you need to find A first. A comes from TE1, TE2, whatever. Okay, and here. Now, given T is a reflection in the line Y equal to X. Okay, whatever. This one means that reflection T of X and Y, reflection, switching, right? So X, the line Y equal to X. So wherever be X, is gonna be Y. Wherever be Y, is gonna be X. So T X Y equal to Y X. Therefore, you see, the domain we have like order pair, so must be in R2. So E1 comes from 1, 0. E2 gonna be 0, 1. And when you plug in here, you're gonna plug in E1 and E2. And what you're gonna get? You're gonna get TE1, TE2. Oh, if you have up to E3, you just have, if you have in R3, you're gonna have E1, E2, E3. If you are talking about R2, you're gonna have E1 and E2. If you talk about Rn, you're gonna have E1, E2, E3, up to En. Okay, be careful on that. Once you plug in, you get 0, 1, and 1, 0. Here we go. And then use a standard matrix to compute this. That means when you have A, they're telling you that your transform can be in terms of TX equal to AX. And now they want to compute t of 3, 4 is equal to a times 3, 4. A, you know it. Plug in here, times 3, 4, multiply matrix together, you get 4, 3. Here we go. Yay! It's what? Reflection, right? 3, 4 becomes 4, 3. Done. This one gonna be the transformation of a counterclockwise rotation. Okay, this one is a special type of transformation by fixed angle theta. What is that? If you plug in t x y, you need to multiply that x y into here. Okay, I won't check the proof. Let's see example. The question is gonna look like this. Let t be the counterclockwise rotation in R2 by angle 120 degrees. Okay, so now they're telling you that theta equal to 120 and it's in R2, so it's gonna be xy like this. Write down the standard matrix of t. You don't need to look at anywhere. It's tx equal to ax already, so you know a. This one gonna be your standard matrix. See? So A equal to this. But what you need to know, this standard matrix supposed to be belong to T, and T is what? Counterclockwise rotation by angle 120. Plug in the angle. Calculate. Cosine 120 is in what? Quadrant 2. So cosine will be negative. So negative 1 half or 0.5. The sine will be what? Positive. But you have negative in the front, so negative square root 3 over 2. Similarly, you calculate the matrix A. See that? And then compute T of 2, 2. T 2, 2 is equal to A times 2, 2. And A, you know it. Therefore, multiply with 2, 2, calculate the number. If it's under square root, keep it like that. Don't worry. How about projection? Can we find standard basis of the projection? Of course. Let's see that. T will be the projection onto the vector W, right? Star TU equal to projection on of U on W, okay? On W, and they give you the W already. Let's get the general form first. If you plug in any XY, okay? You see the result W will be 2. Order pair, two elements. So the point, any xy here is going to be order pair too. Projection any xy on w will be w dot xy divided by the magnitude of w square times vector w. Okay, plug in w equal to negative. Oops, wrong. Typo again. W is supposed to be this. Okay, let's make it up. You can fix. Let W to be 1 and negative 5. This is wrong. Okay, supposed to be 1, negative 5, and we can move on. Okay, so we have 1, negative 5 times XY, dot XY, and then divided by what? Phi D. Remember how we find the magnitude? Magnitude of A, B will be A square plus B square, right? Because you have square here. 1 square plus negative 5 square will be 26. You do the product here, you get x minus 5y. See, divided by 26 times here. All right, we get it. This is going to be our transformation. Before you do that, come back. The problem asks you find the standard basis or standard matrix. I just said it wrong. Find the standard matrix. So when you see the transformation, you just need to calculate what? A. Matrix A comes from TE1 and TE2, see? And TE1, you plug in 1, 0, x equal to 1, y equal to 0. See, x equal to 1, y equal to 0. This is your TE1. TE2, you plug in x0, y1. This is what you got. Construct TE1, TE2. After you know that, compute T of 2, 3. T 2, 3 comes from A times 2, 3. See? A, you know it. Multiply with this. Multiplying between two matrices, they get the answer. Done. Next. Okay, this one. If you have linear transformation in this form, now find standard matrix A. Okay, let's see the domain. We have order triple. That means you need E1, E2, and E3. All right. Once you need E1, E2, and E3, you plug in, you calculate TE1, TE2, TE3. And then you plug in here, each column, TE1, TE2, second column. Oh, this one have to be TE3. You see the typo here, supposed to be 3. And you plug in here. After that, you want to calculate this. You know A, good to go. T of whatever equal to A times whatever here. T of 2, negative 1, negative 1 will be A times 2, negative 1, negative 1. Calculate and you get the answer. Next, example is about composite between two transformation. All right. So T1 defined like this. T2 defined like this. You see? Compute the standard matrices of T, which is equal to T2 over T1. And T prime comes from T1 over T2. Let's see how we're going to do it. This is T1. This is T2. Remember, each T can construct standard matrix. So I'm going to use T1, plug in E1 and E2, I'm going to get A1. And T2, I'm going to plug E1 and E2 in here, I'm going to get A2. See, T1, E1, T1, E2, I get A1. You plug in E1 and E2, in T2, you're going to get A2. Okay. Once you know A1 and A2, remember, if you want to find standard matrix of T, comes from T2, T1. T2, T1, you're going to get A2, A1. And the standard matrix of T1, T2 comes from A1, A2. Just follow this. So A2 times A1, you get this. And A1 times A2, you get this. You get the answer already. You see, I mentioned that A times B is not equal to B times A. So A2, A1, and A1, A2, they are not the same. Something like this will happen in the exam for sure. Next one. Determine whether T transformation like this is invertible or not. Remember how we check the invertible? You need to find the matrix A. You find the matrix A, you know T, right? T is given, you plug in E1, you plug in E2 because I'm in R2, right? The domain in R2. Once you plug in, you can construct A. And then you just need to find determinant. If determinant is not equal to 0, then T is invertible. But if the determinant of this matrix equal to 0, then it's gonna be what? Singular matrix, so it's not invertible, so the inverse does not exist. Okay, you show invertible, you check if determinant of A equal to 0 or not. Next one. Give you this. Okay. This one, the one that we talk about basis. Skip it. Don't worry. If you see anything about like two basis, that's fine. I mean, you can read it and try to understand that, but I wouldn't take it for your final exam. Yeah, should be that's it. I mean, for the application here, it's gonna be too much. Is that enough for now? So I want you to know the basic linear transformation. I will give you something similar to example. Excuse me, 0.05 A. Let me see that. 3.12. Okay, this one. Fractionate it for E1, y equals 0, so it should be 0 over 26 or not. Okay, let me check this one, right? Okay. And find E. This one, right? Okay. So if you plug E1 into here, I see, I just see the idea. Now let's check the value. You plug in x equal to 1, y equal to 0. The first will be 1 over 26. The bottom, x equal to 1, y equal to 0, will be negative 5 over 26. This is correct. When you find E2, you plug in x equal to 0, y equal to 1, so negative 5 over 26. And E2, you plug the second term, you plug x0, y equal to 1. No, this is correct, right? Nothing's wrong or correct. Because you have the projection, the transform will be this. And yeah. Okay. Yeah, I think this should be enough. What is yes for? you try to answer for me too. Thank you. Okay, let's skip over all about this again. What's important here? I'm gonna ask you to show two things here. Check it, just like example. This is, I want you to know, is it called zero transformation? And this one called identity transformation. The property here, you can use it, especially this one, you see, the transformation can distribute to each linear combination. And for definition of projection, this is, you need to memorize it. And after that, you need to be able to transform, okay? Whatever you plug in here, you transform it to something else that I asked you to do here. It's gonna be given, right? You should be able to write it. And check it if it's linear transformation or not. You need to check by the definition. If one of them fail, you don't need to check the second property. But if the first one satisfy, the next one should be satisfied too, in case of its linear transformation. Let's say I said given T defined like this is linear transformation, show that T is linear transformation. You need to show two properties, preserve additivity and preserve scalar multiplication. Yep. What else you need to know? You need to find A. You have seen many examples already. How are we gonna construct A? This one, I just give you A and Tx equal to Ax. But after that, if you know transformation, you find phi A by using standard matrix, right? TE1, TE2, TE3. Mm-hmm. And if you see in terms of this, if I don't give you the form of linear transformation, but I give you transform of this number equal to this number, transform of this number equal to this number. In this case, what you need to do is just write whatever we want to find here in terms of linear combination of the term that we know first. And after you do that, you just apply transformation and use the property of distributive of the transformation into each term, right? What else? Yep, kernel and range. Kernel is gonna be all the set V, right? That's TV equal to 0. Find all the set that make transformation equal to 0. Range is just range. Like all the W that transform from TV. After that, yeah, this thing gonna be okay for composite. Composition. Be careful about the form here. This one you map from T1 to T2. See? T1 and the end of T2. But if you have T2 or T1, the standard matrix gonna be A2, A1. If you have T1 or T2, the standard matrix gonna be A1, A2, okay? If you switch it off. Yeah, like that. If you can show these two property, then you say T1 and T2 are invertible. When we talk about invertible isomorphism, invertibility, they are exactly the same thing. That means, remember, They ask you, show that if T is invertible, that means A inverse exists. T is invertible or not, that means A inverse exists. A is invertible, that means the determinant of A is not equal to zero. Okay, just in case you can follow. A is invertible. It's the same thing as that A is not zero. Okay, some meaning. What else? Yeah, and this is how you construct the standard matrix. And this one just example of counterclockwise rotation. If I give you something like this, I give you the angle. So you should prepare for the angle. The angle that I'm gonna give you will be something you know, like zero angle, 45 or pi over 4, pi third, pi over 6, pi half, 2 pi third. You know, all the multiple of 0, 45, 30, and 60 degrees around the unit circle. Yep, something about projection. Look at the definition and try to memorize it. I'm not giving it to you because it's not that hard, you see? Projection of whatever on W will be whatever this point dot W divided by W square times W. That's it. Yeah, be careful when you plug in the value. You see, T2 or T1, the standard matrix is going to be A2, A1. If you have T1 or T2, it's going to be A1, A2. Different. So don't assume that they will be the same. This example have shown you already. A1 and A2, A2 and A1. If you switching the multiplication of two matrices, you won't get the same result. Yeah, I want to talk about transition matrix and similarity. Yeah, otherwise you're going to talk about the transpose. We have to talk about rotating. I think it's a lot already for your final exam now. That's it. Any questions? About the final exam, I'm not done yet. Sorry about it. So, okay. So this all done for all the materials that I would like to cover for our final exam. And yeah, you guys should be prepared for that. And good luck on the exam.